Hi there. In today's video, I'm going to teach you a cool music DJ app called Vibo DJ app. It's intended for DJs who do private events like weddings or even corporate events where you need to ask your clients to send you requests. The thing is that this app allows it to be very detailed, very fun, personalized, interactive, and also organized. So that's why I'm teaching it today. I'm DJ Nicole Otero, professional DJ from NYC, and on this channel, I teach beginner and professional DJs how to get started or up-level their business. And if you stick around till the end of the video, I'll show you how you can download my music resource guide where I list my top websites where I get all my music from. And if you like what you see, click subscribe. So let's get started. First thing you would do once you set up an account with Vibo is you would log in. And this is for the back end for the DJ. You log into the desktop version, login 2.0. And then you want to sign in. Then you want to sign in. And I have a lot of different events already created. So you see here is how I sift through my events. So let's see, I go into this upcoming event and I have. And you can see that the clients have made a lot of progress. They've picked, you know, they've pretty much answered all the questions and only have 86%, I mean, only have done most of the music selection. If I go to timeline and music, this is what the clients, you know, it's kind of their view on the desktop. And you can see that this timeline was already created. This is my wedding timeline. So if a client goes to ceremony, ceremony begins. It seems like this client I'm not doing the ceremony for, so I would just go to cocktail hour, okay? Cocktail hour, you could see here all the music that they've selected, all right? And a lot of times for cocktail hour, we don't actually have to DJ live because it's a different setup. You're just kind of playing a playlist. So now I could go export Spotify. And you can see here, I could decide which section it is that I want to export to Spotify. So if I go to cocktail hour music, I go next and then export to Spotify. And I can also open this up to Spotify. So it says that it's successfully done it, but I could go open on Spotify. And now you can see this is in my account. And if I want to actually open it up in Spotify, just go open up my Spotify app and it will be in there. So that's pretty awesome. And let's see what else. So let's say you want to go down to open dancing music now, right? So I've clicked this section and you can see all the songs that they've selected. Now, if I click this check again next to mark best matches, since I have already scanned my musical library, it's trying to match things with my library here. And you can see I have Boogie Shoes, I have Call Me by Blondie, I have SOB, Freedom, Make It Funky. I would have to double check it's the right song, but most of them look like I have it. So let's say I just want to download this and drag it into Serato. I would just go download M3U, click Open Dancing, and then go next. And all selected files, flag unmatched songs. That's okay. I'm gonna go download. And now you see how I have this here, downloaded here. Now if I open up Serato, and I scroll down to the bottom of all my playlists, I drag Serato over and then actually, I would do it the opposite way. I drag Serato over this way, click on the Vibo DJ app, bring this to the right, and let's see, a little bit like this, a little bit like this. Then I just drag this playlist down here, and now look, it's automatically in there. Okay, isn't that great? And then you could always double check and look back and see, did I miss something? Did something not download because it didn't match? And then you could find it, but it's such an easy way to just drag music into your Serato playlist. So that's really convenient for you as the DJ. You have a way of exporting your playlist to Spotify and then also downloading the music and dragging it into Serato. Now, the other part I really like, and you know, each section has questions you're going to see. But if you want to get into the actual like questions for like what you would be emceeing at a wedding. You have to be in timeline and music. That's like where they were able to answer questions. And this template was actually handed off to me and I liked it. But all the templates I have are here. So I have one for a complete timeline of a wedding and then one for just a party in case you wanted to use this for clients who just have like a corporate event or party and they want, you know, but you can create your own template here and create whatever template you want. Now, the other thing that I really love about this is, let's say I go into this event, let's say I have all my notes, you know, I could go to PDF version. All right. And then I can have DJ notes in there, event info on, or I could have DJ notes on if I want. It depends. And if you've written any notes in the timeline and music, like for instance, sometimes, let's see, there's toast. There's three toasts here. So this note section here is really good to kind of copy and paste their answers in, right? So this is like for toast, I need to announce that. So I'm going to copy this and then I'm going to paste it and leave this here. I go save, right? So now if I go into PDF version and I say download PDF, download. Okay. And I click the PDF. Now it opens up into this amazing just timeline for yourself and you can print this and now you have notes and very legible and very organized way as an MC to just read things off, right? Because when I'm MCing these events, I don't want to just rely on what's on my computer, especially if I'm like doing quick cues and things like that, because I need to see what's happening on Serato while I'm DJing, not just looking at this. So that's the desktop version. I'd also like to show you how when I do have an event, I have a company and I have a bunch of DJs, right? I'm not the only DJ. So let's say this event belongs to one of my DJs. What I would do is I come here and I go manage DJs. Now I have paid for each DJ to have their own account, but I would go manage DJs and then I could just type in one of my DJs' names. Let's see. Okay. And one of my DJ's names is Ozzy and she just shows up and then I would say assign event. And then she is able to access this timeline on her end too. So that's really helpful. And that's pretty much all I use, you know, this app for. I use a timeline and music for, you know, this is how my clients input their information. I use the prep mode for when I'm prepping for the back ends, like, you know, exporting to Spotify and then also bringing my things into Serato DJ Pro and then PDF when I'm ready to print. So now let's go into the iPhone version, or you could use a Samsung, and how I create the event in there and how I invite my clients to this timeline so they could start inputting data. So let's go do that now. So now we're going to go over how to create an event with the Vibo app on your phone and then send an invite to your client, because this is how your client will be inputting their music selection or any other notes. So I would first find my Vibo DJ app. And then I would go to, this is my events section, right? But I would go to new event. And I would just title it whatever it is. I'm just going to say test Vibo event. I would put the date. Let's say it's tomorrow. I would put the event type. So here is where I already have different templates. So I would go to wedding. And actually, that's just the event type, not the template. Here is where I choose my template. So Vibo kind of gives you a whole bunch of different templates that you could run from their previous clients, which is awesome. So this is one that I like for myself. It's a wedding complete timeline. You can add a picture here, or your clients can add a picture there. And then you could put the location of the event. I'm just going to say, let's say the River Cafe. I do a lot of things there. Okay. And then I would go done. And once that's done, then I can invite people. So I go invite people. I hit invite people. I go invite a host, because your clients will be hosts. And then I could send a text message, put their phone number, and then this is the message that they get. And when they get this message, they're able to download the whole link, and it will open up to their wedding timeline that will look like this. So, and what we saw on the desktop. So it's super easy. It's super fun. And I'm telling you, my clients love it, because aren't we all on our phones all day anyway? So why not make this process for our clients a little bit more personalized and easy to use for them? So I hope you enjoyed today's video. As promised, if you would like my music resource guide, just scroll to the bottom of this video and you will see a link. Just click there and you'll be able to access it. I'm DJ Nicole Otero, professional DJ from NYC, and on this channel, I teach beginner and professional DJs how to get started and up-level their business. As always, if you like what you see, click subscribe. All right, see you next time, DJ. Bye.